Hello everyone, I am Dr. Yogesh Pawde. I am associated with Department of Biochemistry inside GS Medical College and KEM Hospital, Mumbai. I welcome you to the session in this lecture series on clinical enzymology. Before going through this session before you watch this video, I will recommend you go to the playlist on clinical enzymology and watch the first video in which we have covered general enzymology and the properties of isoenzymes, and then come back and watch this video and understand the enzymatic cardiac markers which are going to be covered in this session. Transaminases, that are serum aspartate transaminase and serum alanine transaminase, first will be covered in this session. So coming to the specific learning objectives of this session, we have kept precise specific learning objectives of this session as: at the end of the session, students shall be able to describe the utility of serum aspartate transaminase and alanine transaminase in clinical management of myocardial disorders and hepatic disorders, describe individual characteristic pattern of rise, peak and fall of enzymatic cardiac marker. Coming to the aspartate transaminase, its enzyme classification number is 2611. It is L-aspartate 2-oxoglutarate aminotransferase. This difference between aspartate and alanine transaminase is very important. Aspartate transaminase is both mitochondrial and cytosolic, whereas alanine transaminase is only cytosolic. Normal reference range is 4 to 17 international unit per liter, and it is approximately 10 to 35 King Armstrong units. This is a chemical reaction catalyzed by aspartate transaminase. So one pair of amino acid and keto acid is forming a new pair of L-glutamate and oxaloacetate. Okay, just a transfer of amino group from amino acid to keto acid via the agency of pyridoxal phosphate. Okay, so the AST catalyzes with the via the agency of pyridoxal phosphate, and pH requirement is 7.4. Coming to the alanine transaminase, its enzyme classification number is 2.6.1.2. It is L-alanine 2-oxoglutarate aminotransferase. Only the amino acid is changed in the name. Only cytosolic enzyme. So there may be an MCQ on this point, which is very important. So aspartate transaminase is both mitochondrial and cytosolic, whereas the alanine transaminase is only cytosolic enzyme. Normal reference range for AST and ALT is almost similar. Here for ALT it is 3 to 15, which is 6 to 23 King Armstrong units, and this is a typical chemical reaction catalyzed by alanine transaminase. Okay, here only the amino acid is changed, that was L-aspartate, here it is L-alanine. Okay. The transaminase activities in human, this needs to be studied to understand the utility of transaminase in diagnosis of myocardial infarction in older days. Okay, and we have discussed the history using enzymes for diagnosis, which started in 1956. Okay, so initially LDH and AST ALT were used for diagnosis of myocardial infarction. If you compare the AST activity and ALT activity in tissues like heart, liver, compared to the serum activity, if we consider serum activity of AST1, you will see that the activity of AST in heart is 7800 times and in liver it is 7100 times. Okay, so it is almost similar, right? If you compare ALT activity, if we take serum activity of ALT as a constant 1, okay, and you will see that the ALT activity in heart is 450 times, but in case of liver it is 2850. because it's a cytosolic enzyme and most of the chemical reactions are metabolic reactions are occurring in cytosol. The activity of ALT in liver tissue is more compared to heart because myocardium has most of the mitochondrial part. Okay, that's why the activity of AST is more in case of heart compared to ALT activity. And whenever we study transaminases, even for hepatitis also, we do not perform or investigate AST or ALT individually. Both the transaminases are tested together so that we get a fair idea about AST to ALT ratio. Okay, so if we consider ALT to AST ratio, that will be more in case of heart disorder and that will be less in case of liver disorder because the ALT component will be more in case of liver disorder. Coming to the clinical significance of transaminases, both the transaminase activity is increased in myocardial infarction. It is not like only AST will increase, both will increase, but the extent of rise of AST will be more in case of myocardial infarction compared to ALT. Then there are disorders, liver disorders, where you will find this ratio being more in case of this AST to ALT ratio is more in case of alcoholic hepatitis, hepatic cirrhosis and liver neoplasia, where you'll see the rise in AST is more compared to ALT paradoxically, and rest of the other disorders will show you rise in ALT more compared to that of AST. Okay, so these three conditions, alcoholic hepatitis, hepatic cirrhosis and liver neoplasia, will show you extent of rise of AST more compared to that of ALT. So these conditions may mimic as myocardial infarction. So clinical correlation will also be there, which will not affect your diagnosis, though the ratio indicates myocardial infarction because AST is more compared to ALT. Non-alcoholic steatohepatitis and drugs like NSAIDs, non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, antibiotics, antiepileptic statins, opiates will increase the transaminase activity because all the drugs are going to be metabolized in liver. So that will increase the AST and ALT activity so that the drugs get metabolized. Here we will study the characteristic pattern of rise, peak and fall in myocardial infarction. The aspartate transaminase typically starts rising after 12 hours, reaches peak level at 24 hours and returns to baseline in 3 to 5 days. Since we are not using it, but it as it is kept in the course content, we have to study this. So thank you very much. Guys, if you find this content useful for your studies and it gives you a good idea of enzymatic cardiac markers, so I'll request you to like and share the video, and at the same time I'll request you to subscribe to the channel to get notified about the upcoming videos, and please press the bell button so that you get the notifications in real time. Thank you so much. Thanks for watching and please keep motivating us. Thank you so much.